out there entertain without anxious, without knowing it. At this time, we invite all first-time visitors to please stand. Welcome, Angels to Grace United Church of Christ, where our pastor is Reverend Melody L. Seaton. We pray that you feel the hospitality of our ministry throughout this service, and we'll come again. Our worship shall share information about our church. The same information can be found on our website at www.grucc.org. If you feel led to join us, please walk any hour when our pastor or the door of the church after the service. If you are visiting us on social media, we invite you to our website for an e-membership form. If you're interested in joining, be blessed and have a wonderful week.
Thank you. all of y'all. That was the best person ever.
Because you should
old insurance policy or something, okay? Now read the fine print. You gotta live, I think, about 2 years before you can collect. But you can get something. And that's $10 a month, right? No medical check, none of that. Let's stop being trifling and do the right thing. Amen?
Amen.
All right. Whew, the last thing I want to talk about, it's going to be brief, because y'all already know my friend, Pastor T, my good girlfriend, who seems to know in the spirit when I need a phone call from her. She sends me her word that she puts out on social media every single day. I'm so grateful. She doesn't have to take the time to do that. But she knows how busy I am, that I'm not always on social media. And so every day I get to hear her voice. Every day I get something to uplift me. I'm so grateful to my mom and dad for introducing me to her. Everybody, even Pastor me, somebody they can depend on.
Amen.
And so my sister, Pastor Teresa, is that person. She's one of the people that God has sent. And I love her dearly. And I'm just blessing God that she always makes time to come and be with us. Because she's traveling, you know? She got to either drive or get on a plane and come here and preach to us. And so I'm praying not only that she has travel mercies back, everybody that might have come with her, but that y'all receive the word that she's going to give, that God has blessed her.
Amen.
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 All right, amen. 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 So Rose, you might be next. We bless God for this opportunity to break the bread and pour the wine, pour the wine and break the bread.
Sir, I just have to do this. This has nothing to do with communion, but I just have to do this. There is no secret what God can do, what He's done for us. He'll do for you. With His arms wide, God, we confess that we are in bondage to sin and
cannot free ourselves. We have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. For the sake of Jesus Christ, have mercy on us. Forgive us. Renew us so that we may delight in your will and follow in your ways to the glory of your name. Amen. You may be seated. Let us pray. Oh Lord, hallelujah for the things that you have done, Father. We stand in your presence right now, God, asking you, oh God, to search us and know us, oh God. If there's anything that is not like you, God, remove it, oh God. As we prepare to take the bread and drink the wine, oh God. You said we do this in remembrance of you, Father. But we want to have a pure heart as we do this, God. So search us, Father. Anything that is not like you, remove it, oh God. And for this we give you thanks.
Yes.
For this we give you honor. And for this we give you all the glory. In Jesus' mighty name.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen.
So the Lord took the bread and he raised it up and he gave thanks for this bread. He said, this is my body broken for you. As often as you do this, you do it in remembrance of me. Let us eat together. And in the same way, hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Scripture said, don't let familiarity breed in you. Sometimes we can get so repetitious because of the same thing. But this has meaning.
Hallelujah.
Because the Lord gave himself for us.
Yes.
In the same way he took the cup. He said, this is the covenant, the new covenant of my blood. And I pour out for you and you. Let us drink together. Hallelujah. Father, we thank you. Oh God, as we break the bread, we drink the wine. And now it's time for us to go out and tell our story of what you have done for us. We give you thanks and we give you praise for the mighty thing that you have done. And for this we say thank you. In Jesus' name. Victory is mine. Victory is mine. Victory today is mine.
www.grucc.org/giving. For bill pay, contact your bank. For cash app, dollar sign GUCC 2500. Or you can mail a check directly to the church. For Zelle, it's rep.seaton@grucc.org.
Clothed in our right mind with the activities of our being, O God. are always providing and making ways for us in capacities unexpected. As we enter this new week, I pray to do something supernatural, something only you can do, God, that we can say God is. God, we thank you right now that you brought us together in this appointed moment before the foundation of the world to let us hear the word on today. Father God, we thank you for our guest speaker, Pastor Teresa Brown. We pray for her strength and her guidance. Give her the strength and courage in time of difficulty, God, as she prepares to preach your word, Father God. Continue to lead her with love and with your truth so that she may live a life that brings glory to your name. Lord God, we thank you for bringing us to our 10th year of ministry. Our 10th year of being able to worship, praise, honor, and love you, O God. Lord God, we thank you for our pastor, Reverend Melanie Elsie. I pray she has your heart, Lord, as she leads in the position you have called her to lead. I pray you renew her strength daily. Make her ready to receive your joy.
Yes, God.
God, I ask that where there has been worry, I pray that your spirit will confront it. Thank you for keeping her, O God, on the days that she may think she will make it, but you sent a fresh wind. Thank you, God, that her best days are still ahead of her, and that the week will be ready for the best tonight. Oh God, her courage is impeccable, and we pray to keep her in perfect peace. Oh God, while we wait on our greatest blessings, I ask that you mold our hearts and strengthen our spirits, O God. Let our desires align with your plans. And God, I thank you for every person under the sound of my voice. I pray that they are blessed and will continue to be blessed in their comings and goings, O God. Bring clarity to their minds, bring joy to their souls. I pray you give them a peace that surpasses all understanding.
Yes, God.
May you pour on the inside. And if anything that is not of you, remove it and increase everything that is. I ask that you will help them heal the things that they have gone, on slowly. Restore our vision, O God, towards everything we overlooked that you needed us to see. We thank you, Lord God, for our triumphs, and we also thank you for our pain. Remind them that you are very intentional when it comes to them, Lord God. Remind them that we serve a God that does everything but fail. Lord, we fully surrender these last few months to you, saying yes to your will and yes to your ways. Oh God, I ask that you follow us every day of the week. Bless our Monday, our Tuesday, our Wednesday, our Thursday, our Friday, our Saturday, and our Sunday, oh God. I pray that you make all of our wrongs right and help us to remember that your word says, let us not grow weary in doing what is right, for we will reap that harvest time if we do not give up. Lord God, we thank you for just being able. Thank you for just sitting in this moment with us. Today we leave it all at your feet, oh God. Pour out all new things into our life that eyes haven't seen and ears haven't heard. With faith, we receive your blessings and walk boldly in the purpose you have ordained for us. And it is in your name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
I need my hand. Genesis is the first book. Revelation is the last book. Amen. Amen, amen. Giving honor to God, who's truly the head of my life. Giving honor to Reverend Mel. 10 years. Ah, 10 years. Amen. To Grace United Church and to my family, my child, my children watching, to everybody in the house. Amen. If you got Revelation, say amen. If you're still flipping, say wait. Amen. Revelations chapter 3, verses 14 through 16. I am in the King James Version Bible. It reads, unto the angel of the church of Laodicea write, these things said the Amen, the faithful and true witness, the beginning of creation of God. I know thy works, thou art neither cold nor hot. I would that thou were cold or hot. So then, because thou art lukewarm and neither cold nor hot, I will spew thee out of my mouth. Amen. And as you take your seat, I just want to use the subject. You can't keep running in and out of my life. Amen. Have you ever been in a relationship with someone and you were on again and off again? This craziness went on in the relationship for quite a while until finally you concluded either we're going to be together or we're not.
Laodicea was located 50 miles southeast
bottom. And we think that the service can't go on or God's kingdom won't be advanced because if I don't do it, then God, it won't be done. God, let us know, I really don't need you. There's a wino on the corner that wanted to be you, and all I have to do is tap him on the shoulder and the bottle or go in the track. He may come up in the church and right with the bottle in his pocket and still got a word for you. We act like that we don't need Jesus. So we act like this self-sufficient man or woman, and we really be telling Jesus, I make my own money. So what are you really here for? I don't need you, Jesus. We chucked the land, don't see you. We wealthy, Jesus. We don't need you. And so here it is. It says in Revelations 3:17 through 18, it says, because thou sayest, I am rich and increased with goods, and have need of nothing, and knowest not that thou art wretched and miserable and poor and blind and naked, I counsel thee to buy of me gold, tried in the fire, that thou mayest be rich, yes, and white raiment, yes, that thou mayest be clothed, and that thy shame of thy nakedness do not appear, and anoint thine eyes with eye salve, that thou mayest see. They were so blinded by their wealth that they didn't even recognize they needed a Savior. It is something how we can allow our money and our possessions to make us think that we're in right relationship with the Lord, and say, look at what all I got. And we could be like the man that didn't read the word to say, you fool, your soul is required of you this day. What type of relationship are you in? Are you running in and out of the Lord's life? While you got money, you don't need the Lord. You don't even have a prayer life. But as soon as the money runs out and your friends get filled, you want to be like the old saints say, people. But it's better to have a church packed with folks who give their heart to the Lord.
Right.
And we see God's grace in this whole conversation over there in Revelation 3:19.
these are convenience.
Preach.
I gotta clean myself up before I go to church. Well, these are convenience. And I'll get them on the back end. No, we gotta treat God like a priority, because his priority today may be your number. It's up. That may be his priority today, because I didn't treat him like a priority. Woo!
Jesus.
He knocking on the door of a heart. And this is the thing. If you don't let him in your heart, you can't get in his house.
Yes.
He got rules of coming in his house. Mm. How many of you got rules about people that come in your house?
Oh, yeah.
Y'all got rules. Take your shoes off. Stop walking on the carpet. You don't let go on my refrigerator.
Right in. Yes.
We thank you, God. We ask that you
Lord, come on. Lord, come on and give it up for my friends. Us, you know, Jesus, Paul, and all them, they met people where they were. That's why y'all knew what she was talking about. It took you back somewhere. But I bless God for that word, because that is my prayer as we now move into the next years and decades, that we get serious about this. We're not. The thing of it is, if one is not saved, it spoils a whole bunch. If one is not doing what the Word of God says, it reflects on everybody. And what we're doing makes no difference. People can't get beyond the negative stuff. It discounts all. I cannot impress that enough. We are required to love. And I know sometimes it's hard. But sometimes it's in degrees. Ain't that right? When you're married, those of y'all that's married or in a relationship, you don't love that person every day the same way. I'm going to tell the truth now. You know, some days you be like, catch me in about 15 minutes. Really, seriously.
Right.
We got to be honest about that. It doesn't mean you don't love them and you don't want to be with them for the rest of your life or whatever commitment you made. It's just that some days I ain't feeling you today. But we can't do that with Jesus.
That's right.
We can't do it. We got, but you know, we still got to come and move together. So I bless God for you. Thank you, Pastor T. Thank you for that prayer. I pray that God replenishes the sister. And she had a long drive home. And if you are without a church home, I invite you to walk the aisle. Give me your hand and give God your heart. The Lord has plenty of work in the vineyard. And as we go into this next season, we invite you to join us. We are so grateful to God for all that God has given us to do. And we got more love, more hands, more ministry in order to go on, because God is requiring that of us. The doors of the church are open. You are without a church home. We want you to know that you are welcome here. Our ministry of feeding the people and feeding our members is very important to us. But not just anything. That's why we have an organic farm in the bank. Because we want to feed people what's going to keep them alive. You know, to the time that God